Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. So in this video we are going to know the pH and TDS requirements in hydroponic plants. So first we will understand what is pH and TDS and how to measure them. Then we will know the right pH and TDS level for plants, and lastly we'll know how to balance them in hydroponics. So guys, in hydroponics, the growth of the plant majorly depends on the pH of water and the nutrient solution. As there is no soil to provide the nutrients required, the solution must be added in the right amount. Further, the pH and the TDS level must be adjusted in accordance to the plant characteristics. If a plant is not grown healthy, the analysis of nutrition solution in hydroponics should be done to know the symptoms and then adjust the nutrition solution. So pH, basically called as the potential hydrogen, is a measurement from 1 to 14 of the acidity or alkalinity of the nutrition solution, with 1 being acidic and 14 being alkaline. So basically it determines how many nutrients are absorbed by your plants. It can be known by using the pH sensor and can be adjusted using the pH up and pH down solutions available in the market. You can also get these items in the Amazon too. For determining the TDS level or total dissolved solids, which is measured in ppm or the EC of the solution, you can purchase the TDS or EC sensors. Basically, these sensors give the same result, which is 1 EC is equal to 700 ppm. These readings measure the nutrients contained in the hydroponic solution, but these sensors measure the mix of all the nutrients in the solution. It cannot separately measure a particular solution. So now let's understand the right pH level required for the plant for a healthy growth. If the level is correct, then it'll make the plants grow faster by increasing their metabolism rate. But if they are not used rightly, it can have a harmful effect to the plants. The standard pH range of hydroponic plants is 5.5 to 6.5. The pH ranges of many fruits are around that range, with an exception of blueberry with a pH range of 4 to 5. Whereas the pH range of vegetables are slightly more alkaline than fruits, with most of the vegetable ranging from 6 to 7, having exceptions of artichoke, which is above the pH range, and taro, which is below the pH range. While the pH range gap in certain vegetables such as kale, asparagus, garlic, cauliflower, and beans is very broad and are more alkaline than other plants, so these are easier to maintain. Next, the pH ranges of herbs are standard, but they are very narrow and precise, with a range gap of 0.5 pH, except in oregano with a range gap of 2 pH. So it's a little difficult to maintain the pH of herbs as the range gap is less. So guys, in case your pH level is lower than required, then plants can have symptoms of magnesium deficiency or iron and aluminium toxicity. On the other hand, if the pH level is higher than required, then plants cannot absorb calcium and phosphorus properly, having poor growth of plants. So when your plant is at a growth stage, you need to check the pH levels every day. So now coming to the TDS level of hydroponic plants, it mainly depends on three factors: the stage of the growth, the type of plant, and the environmental changes. A constant check of the TDS level is required with the change in all these factors. According to the stage of growth, first, a seedling requires a ppm of 100 to 300. Normally, filtered water has such ppm, so it requires very less nutrients. Secondly, during the vegetation cycle, the plant requires 300 to 700 ppm. At this stage, plant requires more nitrogen nutrients than other. Thirdly, at the first half of the flowering, the plant requires 700 to 950 ppm. And at the second half, the plant requires 950 to 1600 ppm because the plant fruits take up maximum amount of nutrients. Lastly, when the harvest time comes, the tank should be emptied and fresh nutrients should be poured. These ppm readings are standard for most of the plant, but may differ slightly for few plants such as taro, eggplant, broccoli, and few others whose ppm levels are higher, and for plants such as lettuce, lavender, and fennel, the ppm levels are lower. Looking at the type of plant, leafy greens generally require low ppm levels for plant growth, with an exception of pak choi and spinach, which require higher ppm levels, whereas flowering fruits and vegetables require much higher ppm level than leafy greens, where for plants such as eggplant and broccoli, it could go as high as 2000 ppm. Then your nutrient water temperature should not drastically change. The ideal temperature for hydroponic plants is 72 to 75 degrees Fahrenheit. If the nutrient water temperature is high, then plant leaves shuts down and tend to fall. And if it's low, then your plants would grow slower than usual. So for balancing the pH and TDS level, you need to have the constant check on all the three factors discussed before, because both the pH and TDS are connected to each other, as the increase in pH levels can affect the TDS levels, and the change in TDS level by adding the nutrients can affect the pH level of water. So guys, thank you for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. If yes, then please like and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more such videos.